Morning children, how are you all? Did you all do the homework given in the last class? Did you draw the diagram of a flowering plant? Okay, very good. I hope that you all got the textbook. Today let us study about the structure of a leaf. You know, there are different types of leaves. You all have seen the leaves. Do you think all the leaves are alike? No. Some leaves are very big, some are very small, some leaves have different shape. But basically, all the leaves have a common structure. Let us study about the structure of a leaf. Here you can see a leaf. Which plant is this? You know, it is the twig of a hibiscus. Here you can see the leaves. This is only a branch of the hibiscus. Here you can see the leaf. What is a leaf? Leaf is the flattened green part of the plant. Flattened. It is flattened green part of the shoot system or the plant. Okay. How the leaf is attached on the stem? It has a stalk here. Can you see this? The leaf attached on the stem with the help of a stalk. This leaf stalk is called petiole. What is that? Petiole. You are hearing this term first time. So petiole. The leaf attached on the stem with the help of a leaf stalk. Or petiole. In some plants, there will be no petiole. The leaves directly attached on the node. Such leaves are called sessile leaves. So leaves may have a petiole. Such leaves are called petiolate leaf. And sometimes the leaves are attached on the stem without a petiole. Such leaves are called the sessile leaves. Okay, then here you can see the angle. You have studied this. This part is called the axil. Here there is a small bud. You can see here. Here there is a bud. That is called axillary bud. This axillary bud may grow into a branch or a flower. So axillary bud. And here, look at the bud. Here you can see the structure of a typical leaf. So the petiole, the leaf arises from the stem. The point on which the leaf arises is called the node. And it has a stalk, that is the petiole. Then the stalk extends up to the tip of the leaf. Here you can see the leaf stalk extends up to the tip of the leaf. The tip of the leaf is called the apex. And this petiole continues up to the tip of the leaf. And that is called the midrib. This part is called the midrib. You can see the midrib on the leaf. Here, see, look at this leaf. You can see the, here you can see the petiole. The petiole extends up to the tip of the leaf. Here is the midrib. I think all of you can see this midrib. And from the midrib arise there are many branches. These branches and that branches rebranch. So that is called the veins. So from the midrib arise many branches. They are the veins. And they branch again from the veinlets. So veins and veinlets. The main vein is called the midrib. That is in the center. Then the flat part of the leaf is called the leaf lamina or the leaf blade. Here you can see the green flat part. That is this part. The entire green part is called the leaf lamina or the leaf blade. And the edge of the leaf is called the leaf margin. See this edge. Boundary, or we can say the edge of the leaf is called the leaf margin. So these are the parts of a leaf. Listen once more. Here the leaf arises from the stem. The point at which the leaf arises is called the node. The leaf attached on the stem with the help of a petiole. Some leaves have no petiole. Such leaves are called the sessile leaves. And the petiole extend up to the tip of the leaf. The tip of the leaf is called the apex. So the petiole extends up to the tip of the leaf, that is, and form the midrib. That is a very thick structure you can see. This is the structure. That is called the midrib. And from the midrib arise many branches. They are the veins. And the flat green part of the leaf is called the leaf lamina or the leaf blade. And the border or the this edge of the leaf is called the margin. So these are the, and here you can see an axillary bud. In the axil of the leaf, that is the angle formed between the leaf and the stem, that is called the axil. In the axil there is a bud that you learned in the last class, that is called the axillary bud, that grows into a branch or a flower. Okay. So the vein, midrib and the veins together gives support to the leaf. So we can say these veins and midribs together, we can say the skeleton of the leaf. It gives support to the leaf. Then next, the types of the leaves. There are two types of leaves: simple leaf and compound leaf. Here you can see from a node only one leaf arises. Such a type of leaves are called simple leaves. But in some plants we can see from a node two or three leaves arise. Such types of leaves are called compound leaves, as in rose plant. You might have seen the leaves of the rose plant. In that, two leaves. That means here you can see, and it is not a branch. Here there is one leaf, here another leaf, and again one more leaf, and here one leaf. Like this. So this type of leaf is called the compound leaf. Here each small leaf is called the leaflet. And this is the simple leaf. Simple leaf means only one leaf arises from a node. That is called a simple leaf. And here you can see a simple leaf. This is a simple leaf. A single leaf. Okay. And here this is a compound leaf. This is another type of leaf. Here you can see it is a compound leaf. Here each small leaf is called the leaflet. This is the leaflet. This each one is called the leaflet. And this is another type of compound leaf. Here you can see this leaf, you are familiar with this leaf. It is the leaf of the tapioca. Here it is a compound leaf. You can see the compound leaf. So here it is a one leaf only, but you can see there are many small leaflets. Okay. Then that's all about the types of the leaves. Then here itself you can see the different types of leaves, the sides of the leaf. Some leaves are elongated, some leaves have a conical end, some leaves have the entire margin, some leaves are round. Like that, there are different types of leaves. Next one is the arrangement of leaves on the stem. How the leaves are arranged on the stem? There are three types of arrangement of leaves on the stem. The pattern of arrangement of leaf on the stem is called phyllotaxy. Here in this diagram, you can see one leaf arises from a node, as in hibiscus. Here you can see one leaf arises from a node, and the another leaf arises from the next node. Here the next leaf, here the next leaf. So here in this plant, from a node, one leaf arises,
and the another leaf arranged from the next node, that is the opposite side. Look at this, one leaf to this side and another leaf to this side. This type of arrangement is called alternate arrangement. Alternate philotaxy or alternate arrangement. What is that alternate arrangement? One leaf arranged from a node and the next leaf arranged from the next node, that is to the opposite side. The next leaf to this side. So this type of arrangement is called alternate arrangement, as in hibiscus. Then you can see another. Here, another type of arrangement is called the opposite philotaxy. Opposite philotaxy means, here this is a jasmine. Here in this you can see one leaf, two leaves arise from a node in two direction. One is to this side, one is to this side. Here you can see two leaves, one to this side and one to this side. So this type of arrangement, that is opposite. So this type of arrangement is called opposite philotaxy. So alternate means like this. One leaf from a node, another leaf from the next node, again another leaf. Then opposite means from a node, one leaf to this side and one to this side, and here to this side and this side. That is called opposite philotaxy. Then another type of arrangement of leaf is whorled. W-H-O-R-L-E-D, whorled. Whorled means round. In that, from a node, many leaves arise. That means, from here is a node. You just think about a node. In this, one leaf, then another one. There are many leaves arise from a node. Then the next one from here. Many leaves like this. This type of arrangement is called whorled philotaxy, as in Nerium plant or oleander. In each case you have to learn the examples. So these are the three types of arrangement of leaves on the stem. The pattern of arrangement of leaves on the stem is known as philotaxy. So, alternate philotaxy, opposite philotaxy and whorled philotaxy. Next is the venation. Venation means the arrangement of veins on the leaf lamina. What are veins? Veins and veinlets form the skeleton of the leaf, or they give support to the leaf. So the arrangement of veins and veinlets on the leaf lamina is known as venation. There are two types of venation found in leaves. They are reticulate venation and parallel venation. Reticulate venation and parallel venation. Here look at this diagram. Here you can see the veins and veinlets are irregular in the leaf. There is no particular arrangement. They form an irregular network. As seen in this leaf, you can see there is a midrib. You can see a midrib and there are many other veins, and they form an irregular network. This type of arrangement of veins in the leaf lamina is known as reticulate venation. Usually in almost all the dicot leaves, dicotyledonous plant, the leaves of the dicot plants have the reticulate venation. Then another type of venation found in the leaf is parallel venation. Parallel means, as seen in the banana leaf, there you can see here there is a midrib, and from the midrib the other veins are parallel like this. They are parallel to each other, as in banana leaf. So this type of arrangement is called parallel venation. They are parallel to each other. The veins are parallel to each other. Have you seen this leaf? It is the leaf of a banana plant, banana leaf. So the veins are parallel to each other. So reticulate venation and parallel venation. In reticulate venation, the midrib and other veins form a network, irregular network. That is the reticulate. But in parallel venation, there is a midrib. From the midrib, the other veins are parallel to each other. That's all about the structure of the leaf, phyllotaxy, venation, and the type of the leaf. Next is the functions of the leaf. What is the main function of the leaf? You have studied in the lower classes that the leaves prepare the food. How do leaves prepare the food? By which process? Anybody can say? By which process plants prepare the food? Yes, okay. That is photosynthesis. So one of the main functions of the leaf is photosynthesis. Prepare the food. That is the main function. The first function of the leaf is photosynthesis. And the second function of the leaf is transpiration. Let us see one by one. Photosynthesis. You all know the leaves of the plant prepare the food using carbon dioxide and water. They take carbon dioxide from the air. They absorb carbon dioxide from the air. And the roots absorb water from the soil. Using carbon dioxide and water, plants prepare the food in the presence of sunlight. For preparing the food, plant need a substance. Why the leaves are green in color? It is due to the presence of a pigment called chlorophyll. So the leaves contain the green pigment called the chlorophyll. By using chlorophyll, in the presence of sunlight, taking carbon dioxide and water, the leaves prepare the food. That process is called photosynthesis. During photosynthesis, the leaves take carbon dioxide from the air and give out oxygen. That oxygen is used by all other organisms for respiration. So that in the lower classes you learned that plants purify the air. Now you got the idea how the plants purify the air. That is, they take carbon dioxide from the air and give out oxygen. So, first function of the leaf is photosynthesis. Prepare the food using carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight. Then the next one. Then what is the food prepared by the plant? By using carbon dioxide and water, plant prepare the food. That is glucose. But in plants, the glucose is stored in the form of starch. Okay, only the green parts of the plant can prepare the food. Not only the leaves, if the stem is green, it contains chlorophyll. That green stem also can prepare the food. Then the next important function of the leaf is transpiration. In the beginning of this chapter, you learned that the roots absorb water from the soil. The roots of the plant absorb water continuously. The roots absorb a lot of water. But plant need only a little of water for photosynthesis. Then what happens to the other water? The excess water they give out from the leaves in the form of water vapor. Though they absorb a lot of water from the soil continuously, plant use only a little of water. The excess water they give out to the air in the form of water vapor. That process is called transpiration. So giving out excess water from the leaf in the form of water vapor is called transpiration. What is the importance of transpiration? Why do plants give out this excess water? When the plant roots absorb a lot of water, it can absorb more and more minerals from the soil. And that excess water they give out to the air. That air in the form of water vapor. That water vapor gives the plant a cooling effect. As the leaves give out water into the atmosphere, it can absorb more water from the soil. So it has to absorb more water from the soil. So transpiration gives a cooling effect to the plant. At the same time, it has to distribute the materials throughout the plant. These are the advantages of transpiration. Then let us see once more the photosynthesis. You know photosynthesis, during photosynthesis plants prepare the food. That is the plant use a part of the food for its use. The remaining food they store in the various parts of the plant. Maybe in the root or the seed or the fruit or any other parts of the plant. That is the food we use as our food. At the same time, during photosynthesis, plants give out oxygen. That oxygen is used by all other living organisms for respiration. So the two main functions of the leaf is photosynthesis and transpiration. Prepare the food and give out the excess water from the leaf. That's all about the leaf. Next is the modification of the leaves. That you can study in the next class. To get more idea about the leaf, venation and all, you can see an animation.
Leaf and its structure. Most of you would have drawn a leaf somewhat similar to this leaf here. This simple drawing says a lot about the shape and structure of a leaf. The surface of a leaf is flat and is called the leaf blade or lamina. It is green in color due to the presence of chlorophyll. The large lamina allows to the leaf to absorb sunlight, water, and air for the plant. Now let us use a magnifying glass to look closer at this leaf. Can you see a thick line running through the center? This is the main vein or midrib of the leaf. You can also see many smaller veins originating from the main vein. Veins help to carry water, minerals and food up and down the leaf. The main vein extends into the stalk that helps to attach the leaf to the stem. It helps to conduct water and food between the leaf and the stem. If we look at the leaf under a microscope, we will see numerous tiny pores on the lamina. These pores or openings are called stomata. They are present in large numbers on the lower surface of the leaf. Stomata help in exchange of gases with the environment. In photosynthesis, carbon dioxide enters the leaf and oxygen goes out. The leaves are arranged on the stem in a specific way so that they can absorb the maximum amount of sunlight for photosynthesis. The arrangement of leaves on the stem of a plant is called phyllotaxy. When each leaf arises from a separate node on the stem, the leaves are said to be arranged in an alternate manner. When two leaves arise from a single node, but in the opposite direction, they are said to be arranged in an opposite manner. Sometimes more than two leaves arise from the same node and wrap around the stem. The arrangement is called a whorl. Isn't it amazing to see
functions of leaves? Manufacturing food. The leaf is called food factory of a plant. Green plants can make their own food by photosynthesis. Transpiration. The excess of water absorbed by the root hair is lost through the stomata. Stomata are present in the lower surfaces of the leaves. Gaseous exchange. Exchange of gases occurs during respiration and photosynthesis. Gaseous exchange takes place through the stomata present on the leaves.